Now, in this lecture, let us discuss about the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor with a dielectric slab placed partially between its plates. In the previous topic, you learnt the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor partially filled with a conducting slab. Here we have a dielectric slab in place of the conducting slab. So let us consider a parallel plate capacitor having two conducting plates of area A each, separated by a distance d. A dielectric slab of dielectric constant k is inserted. Dielectric constant k is inserted in between its plates. Its thickness is t, and you must understand that this thickness t is less than d. T can also be equal to d. Now, a positive charge q is placed on this conducting plate, and minus q charge is induced on the earthed plate. So an electric field will be developed, will set up in the free space between the two plates, and this is denoted by E naught. You know that whenever a dielectric slab is placed in a uniform electric field, an induced electric field, also called electric field due to polarization, is developed inside the dielectric slab, and the nature of that field is opposite to, direction of that field is opposite to the direction of the external field. But this is somehow less in magnitude in comparison to the external electric field. Hence, we observe a net electric field inside the dielectric slab. Suppose this is E, but it is somehow less than electric field in free space. Again, you see the effectiveness of field inside the dielectric slab has been reduced. So it will change the effective distance between the two plates. So again, let us find, as you learnt in the previous case, electric field set up in the free space between the two plates of the capacitor is E naught, and it is equal to Q by epsilon naught A. You already learnt it in the previous lecture, that why is it Q by epsilon naught A? It is from positive to the negative plate. You also know the reason for that. After then, electric field set up inside the dielectric slab is E is equal to Q by K epsilon naught A. You see the electric field has been reduced inside the dielectric slab in comparison to the external electric field around it. That is the electric field in the free space. After then, you have to find the potential difference. You know, whenever electric field is in the space, whether it is uniform or non-uniform, the potential difference decreases in the direction of the field. So potential difference developed across the two plates, of the capacitor is V is equal to E naught. You see E naught exists for distance d minus t, because total distance is d, out of which t distance is for dielectric slab. So the free space exists in the space, free space exists in the length, in the distance d minus t, plus E exists for the distance t. Now put the value of E naught. E naught is Q by epsilon naught A d minus t, plus E is क्यू बाय के एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए इंटू टी. आफ्टर देन यू कैन हैव क्यू बाय एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए एज द कॉमन. यू सी इट इज इन बोथ द टर्म्स. सो हियर विल बी डी माइनस टी प्लस टी बाय के. दिस के इज डायलैक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट. यू कैन राइट इट क्यू बाय एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए डी माइनस टेक टी कॉमन. इट इज वन माइनस वन बाय के. सो क्यू बाय एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए डी माइनस टी वन माइनस वन बाय के. एंड फ्रॉम हियर यू कैन फाइंड क्यू बाय वी. यू सी क्यू बाय वी देन दिस टर्म विल बी इन दिस साइड. हियर वी विल राइट इट इन द राइट साइड. सो एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए बाय डी माइनस टी वन माइनस वन बाय के. दिस इज क्यू बाय वी. आफ्टर देन वी हैव टू फाइंड द कैपेसिटेंस. सो देयरफॉर कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ द कैपेसिटर इज सी इज इक्वल टू क्यू बाय वी एंड इट इज इक्वल टू सी इज इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए बाय डी माइनस टी वन माइनस वन बाय के. दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ अ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर पार्शियली फिल्ड विथ अ डायलैक्ट्रिक स्लैब इन बिटवीन इट्स टू प्लेट्स. हैव यू अंडरस्टैंड? ओके. सो दिस इज सी इज इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए बाय डी माइनस टी वन माइनस वन बाय क्यू के. आफ्टर देन यू कैन एनालाइज दिस एक्सप्रेशन. यू सी d minus t 1 minus 1 by k. Whenever there was free space between the two plates, it was only d. Denominator was only d. Now the denominator has been reduced. Denominator has been decreased. But the numerator remains same. Epsilon not a. It was there also whenever the capacitor was having free space between the two plates. So the value of c is increased when a dielectric slab is inserted between the two plates of the capacitor. Is it clear? Okay. Now what will happen if you will completely fill the space between the two plates with the dielectric? Means this T will become D. What will happen when T will become D? So when T is equal to D, you see when T is equal to D, this C will become epsilon not A by D minus T, D minus T, T is D, so you should put D. One minus one by K. It is equal to epsilon not A by D minus D into 1D plus D by K. So ultimately it will be C is equal to K epsilon not A by D. K epsilon not A by D. You already learnt this whenever you were learning the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor without any dielectric medium, means with free space between its two plates. So have a look over the complete derivation. You can pause the video now and then note down all these. Okay, so let us discuss the situation now. You learnt capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor without any dielectric slab, without any conducting slab, means with free space between its two plates. After then you learnt about the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor, partially filled with conducting plate, and then you learnt about the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor, partially filled with dielectric slab. You also learnt completely filled with dielectric slab. So in all the cases you have seen that the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor can be increased by introducing a conducting slab or by introducing a dielectric slab in between the two plates of the capacitor. So with this topic, capacitance of parallel plate capacitor is complete now. In the next lecture, we will be having the informations about the grouping of capacitors. Thank you.